a major step forward for China in its plans to explore the moon. The test shows that China is serious about competing with the US and wants to establish a strong presence in space. So what did China accomplish, and how should SpaceX and the US react? Let's talk more on today's episode of NR Studio. The race to the moon is tighter than ever, especially with China being a strong contender. Every time China takes a bold step, it gets closer to matching or even surpassing other spacefaring nations. On June 17th at 12:30 p.m. Eastern Time, which is 12:30 a.m. in Beijing, China's manned space agency conducted a landmark test at its Gobi Desert launch site. The test, called a pad abort or zero altitude escape test, involved the Manga, China's new manned spacecraft designed to carry astronauts into space and eventually to the moon. During the test, the Manga capsule was secured under the escape tower on the launch pad. When the ignition is triggered, the tower's rocket motor fires, lifting the entire spacecraft into the sky. A moment later, another command turns the capsule into the correct position, and about 20 seconds into the flight, a secondary motor detaches the rescue tower from the capsule. After separating, the capsule deploys its parachute for a safe landing. While this is happening, the cover underneath it opens, inflating an airbag for protection. 2 minutes after ignition, Manga landed safely in a designated area, demonstrating that its rescue system can protect astronauts and bring them back to Earth safely. For those who don't know, Manga is a significant upgrade from China's current Shenzhou spacecraft. It can carry up to 7 astronauts in low Earth orbit, or a smaller crew plus up to 500 kilograms of cargo. The lunar version of Manga will weigh about 26 metric tons, capable of carrying 3 astronauts into lunar orbit, where they will switch to a different lander to reach the surface. According to China's plans for the lunar mission, 2 Long March 10th rockets will be used. One rocket will carry the Manga spacecraft, while the other will carry the lunar lander. Once in lunar orbit, the 2 spacecraft will dock, allowing the astronauts to transfer to the lander. After their mission on the moon, the crew will return to the orbiting Manga and then return to Earth. The abort test is critical to ensuring that the spacecraft's safety systems are working properly. The China Space Administration stressed that escape and rescue capabilities are critical to keeping the astronauts safe during their flights. During an emergency, the system is designed to safely rescue astronauts and help them return safely. Officials said the test confirmed key functions, such as initiating the rescue process, separating components, controlling the trajectory and the life support system on board. It also collected critical flight data to ensure that actual performance matched what was predicted in simulations. The agency said the successful test is a critical step for future lunar missions. The Long March 10th and its Lunar lander are being developed on schedule, with more tests planned as China aims to land humans on the moon around 2030. Unlike previous spacecraft, Manga combines rescue and rescue systems into one design, a departure from the previous Zhenhao design that relied more on rockets to escape while the spacecraft survived. Chinese engineers see Manga as a key spacecraft that will help power the country's space station, lunar exploration, and other human missions for years to come. It's important to note that this is only the second escape flight test in China's spaceflight history, the first coming 27 years ago with Shenhe in 1998. It shows just how important this recent milestone is, especially with China's moon goals. More safety tests are planned for later this year, including a crucial test during a flight abort at peak dynamic pressure. These tests could be conducted at Guchuan or Wenchang on Hainan Island. If they happen at Wang, they could use a modified test vehicle or a Long March 5B with the capsule being retrieved after landing. Meanwhile, work on the Long March 10th and Lunar landers continues alongside the rest. All the pieces must function perfectly and be integrated before China attempts a moon landing later this decade. What do you think of China's rapid progress in human spaceflight? Share your thoughts in the comments. And if you enjoyed this update, please like the video and subscribe to follow SpaceX and the world's journey to the moon and beyond. In addition to the safety test, China has also made another major milestone for its lunar plans. This time, they are focusing on orbital servicing, which is essential for future lunar missions. China is currently conducting rendezvous and docking operations between 2 satellites in geostationary orbit, Shujian 21 and Shujian 25. The effort is part of a larger plan to develop in-space servicing and refueling capabilities. Shujian 21 was launched in October 2021, followed by Shujian 25 in January 2025. The two satellites were initially separated by about 2 degrees in longitude, or about 1,500 kilometers in space. Previously, Shujian 21 completed a critical mission by docking with an inactive navigation satellite, BO2G2, and moving it to a designated area for retired satellites. Shujian 21 has been drifting slowly, likely because its fuel is running low. However, it recently fired up its thrusters and began moving towards Shujian 25. At the same time, Shujian 25 changed its course to approach Shujian 21. They coordinated their movements to conserve fuel during their rendezvous. A week ago, they were expected to meet on the 11th. Although there has been no official confirmation, U.S. reconnaissance satellites may have observed the event. After Shujian 25 docks with Shujian 21, it is expected to demonstrate advanced techniques such as fuel transfer and life-extending support. These technologies could significantly lower the cost of space operations by reducing the need for new satellites and limiting space debris. Most importantly, these technologies are also important for future lunar exploration. The ability to dock and refuel in space will be critical to SpaceX's Starship program, especially for missions to the Moon and Mars. China's progress in this area suggests that it is also preparing for a long-term lunar mission. While this maneuver may not have been part of the original plan, it is an important step. This shows that China is actively developing technologies that will be critical to its future lunar missions. As China's lunar program advances rapidly, it is clear that the U.S., led by NASA and SpaceX, will need to act decisively to maintain its lead in this new space race. The U.S.'s current plans still put it ahead in several key areas. But China's rapid progress raises an important question. How quickly can it catch up or even surpass the U.S. if it continues to move at this pace? In response, both NASA and SpaceX will need to act quickly and smartly. The U.S.'s current lead will not last forever. While the plans look solid on paper, there are challenges ahead for both the government and private sectors, and the stakes are higher than ever. For NASA, the future is increasingly complex. The Space Launch System, SLS, and the Orion spacecraft, the centerpiece of the Artemis program, are facing intense scrutiny. The vehicle has been in development since the early 2010s, and after more than a decade and tens of billions of dollars, it has only completed one mission, Artemis 1, in 2022. While that mission was a success, it highlighted how slow and expensive NASA's traditional approach has been. The SLS is a single-use rocket, meaning none of its major components are reused, a model that is becoming outdated in today's rapidly changing launch industry. Orion, meanwhile, is designed to carry astronauts beyond low Earth orbit, similar to China's capabilities. The Mango spacecraft has had ongoing issues, most notably with its heat shield. NASA is currently preparing the Space Launch System, SLS, and Orion spacecraft for Artemis II, which isn't scheduled to launch until 2026. This will be the second flight for a system that has already consumed vast amounts of resources, more than almost any other project in NASA's recent history. Adding to the uncertainty, both SLS and Orion are on the White House's proposed budget cuts list. If these cuts occur, SLS and Orion could be canceled or scaled back, putting the future of the Artemis program even more at the mercy of SpaceX. Some, especially those critical of rising costs and delays, might see this as good news. But for NASA, it shows a failure to create a robust, long-term plan for exploration. Without a reliable crewed launch system for space, NASA will have to rely more heavily on commercial partners. Now let's talk about SpaceX. They've made great strides in recent years, especially with their Starship program, but they're also starting to face challenges. After reaching some major milestones in 2023, such as a successful launch test and suborbital launch, progress has slowed somewhat. Several key technologies needed for a lunar mission are still not fully ready. For example, Starship has yet to complete a full mission involving orbit, payload delivery, space burn, safe re-entry, or recovery after landing. The refueling system needed for the Artemis III landing is still being developed, and we have yet to see the final design of the crewed version of Starship. Despite these challenges, there is reason to be hopeful. SpaceX has successfully managed the landing of its Super Heavy booster, an impressive engineering feat. They are also building a new launch tower and production facility at their Starbase, which will support the high flight rates needed to test and upgrade Starship. NASA and SpaceX are making good progress toward a lunar mission. Key tests for systems like Starship's airtight chamber and elevator have gone well, and new diagrams show how the spacecraft will help astronauts on the moon. Despite some delays, the Artemis 3 mission is still on track for a possible launch in 2027. If SpaceX can pull off an uncrewed demo landing before then, we could see humans return to the moon before the decade is out. Elon Musk has also proposed a goal of a Mars mission in 2026, showing SpaceX's ambitions for space. Meanwhile, China continues to push hard on its own space efforts, conducting elaborate orbital tests and developing the Long March 10th rocket, the Lanua lunar lander, and the Mango spacecraft. This shows that China is serious about competing with the U.S. in space exploration. Their skill in conducting precise technical tests shows that they are not only keeping up with the U.S. space program, but also laying the groundwork for the next phase of lunar exploration. There is still reason to feel confident. With organizations like NASA and companies like SpaceX leading the way, the U.S. is on track to send astronauts back to the moon before China. Despite the challenges ahead, America's space leadership has always been strong, innovative, and capable of overcoming adversity. As long as we maintain momentum and make smart choices, achieving our goals is possible. The moon race is entering a new and exciting phase. China is making bold moves, but the U.S., with its experience and technology, is still ahead. If current efforts continue, it is not only possible, but probable that America will plant its flag on the moon. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you all for your support.